Time. Meanwhile, today the law surrounding divorce has changed, and now there is a no-fault divorce, which means you no longer have to argue quite so much about what's going on. To tell us more, I'm joined now by Rita Gupta from the Leeper Gupta Family Law Firm. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Now, obviously things have changed here, and this means that when it does come down to the going of separate ways, you don't actually have to have a specific cause. You can say we both now wish to divorce.
Absolutely. So previously you would say that the marriage is irretrievably broken down, but you have to rely on five facts, such as adultery, unreasonable behaviour, which was a very common ground, a desertion, or you have to be separated for a minimum period. That no longer applies. And what you have as of today is a statement of irretrievable breakdown of the marriage, which you can issue a separate application, a sole application, or you can do that jointly. So it has removed any allocation of blame, reference to conduct or fault, and no reasons need to be cited as to why the marriage is broken down.
Now, this obviously will make things, hopefully, a little easier on the whole family in the situation, because, I mean, the acrimonious nature of most divorces up to this point has meant that there's been arguments and more bad feeling than is necessary. It makes it difficult when there's kids involved. But this way, I suppose at least you haven't got to try and agree on someone to blame if you hadn't got a cause in the first place.
No, absolutely. I mean, you have to think why marriages break down. Sometimes people fall out of love. Sometimes they grow apart, but they still have a tremendous amount of respect and regard for each other. And certainly the thought behind this process and the changes has not been to undermine the sanctity of marriage or promote quickie divorces, because I'll detail later that's not the case. But it is, as you say, to ensure that, you know, that we're not going making this an acrimonious process unnecessarily for the people that are involved. And if you have children, the most important thing is that at the end of this process, you can continue to be civil with each other and you can co-parent children. And even adult children, you still have an ongoing connection and relationship. So, you know, actually allocating blame and you know, putting detail as to why that marriage broke down is not a helpful process.
And when it comes down to the settlement itself, is that going to change because of this process? Because often if you've got someone to blame, actually, you may well find a financial settlement goes more towards the partner who's been aggrieved. Yet in this case, where it is no blame, will we see differences, do you think?
Well, it's actually, that is generally not the case. I mean, you can still potentially argue conduct in financial proceedings, but it is rarely done, and then the conduct has to be gross. This process is not going to change how you reach a financial settlement or child arrangement. And probably that's one of the other areas that we do need to address. You know, the pain and acrimony around that process is still there. And this isn't going to be, it may be a simpler process, but it's not going to be easier to exit a marriage per se. And nobody's promoting that this is an online quickie divorce, because it isn't. There are actually timeframes, minimum timeframes, that have been built in.
And what do you anticipate when it comes down to sort of the demise of the to blame, the fault divorce? Do you think that will still continue, particularly if there's an awkward situation anyway?
Well, if you've issued your petition, as it used to be called, before today, then you can carry on with that process under the old law. As of today, you can't do that. I think you have to accept that, you know, if you are you feel that you have been wronged, or you are very, you're distraught at the breakdown of your marriage, those feelings aren't going to magically go away due to a law change. And I think as family lawyers, we have to encourage clients to perhaps seek counselling and early therapy to help them work through those emotions. You know, they're not going to magically disappear. And I think that, you know, it's very important that this process isn't made into a tick box exercise. There's very wide-reaching ramifications of a breakdown of a marriage.
And this will cover all types of marriage, opposite gender, same gender, and also civil partnerships as well?
Absolutely. And, you know, there's a minimum 20-week reflection period built in. So if parties do think they want to explore a reconciliation, they can do so. Similarly, they can try to reach a financial settlement if that's possible, or child arrangements within that period. And you have to be married for 12 months before you can actually issue what is now known as a divorce application. It's not the case that you can get married and then a few days later try and issue an application. That aspect hasn't changed.
So there's some things which have sort of evolved in law, others which are already deemed to be the right way to deal with it, as you say, anything less than 12 months. And When it comes to the likes of those who are in maybe a toxic marriage or victims of domestic abuse, will this make it an easier application for them to be able to try and get away from an abusive partner?
Absolutely. I mean, we've removed most of the grounds for defending. You can't just defend this application anymore. You can dispute it on very narrow grounds, such as jurisdiction or invalidity of marriage, etc. So if you are in a toxic relationship and you want to exit that relationship, I think this new process will help. And I also think because you don't have to allocate blame and you know, provide details and information in that petition, you are not antagonising the other party further and perhaps putting yourself at greater risk. So I think, you know, people who are trapped in these marriages will find this new process beneficial.
Where can we go to find out more information to the help that you can give at Leaping Gupta Family Law?
Well, our website is called ltfamilylawyers.co.uk, and there's some great information also on the Resolution website, which is a family law organisation that's campaigned for many years for this. And, you know, it's got a plethora of information there on their website as well as our own.
So you can check out those details there. Give us that website for yourselves one more time.
It's www.lgfamilylawyers.co.uk.
Well, Rita Gupta from LG Family Lawyers, thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.